This is a quick tutorial on how to define additional rebars in SeismoBuild and SeismoStruct's building modeler. First, we select the Reinforcement tab. And now, we will go through the definition of reinforcing bars for the section, additional to the reinforcing bars, specified using the standard reinforcing patterns. So, we select the Additional Reinforcing Bars button for the start section of the beam. And the window for viewing and modifying the additional reinforcing bars opens. Here, on the right part, we can see our section, while on the left, we can see several options, including adding and removing a bar, selecting a bar for modification, and moving a bar. Then, the menu for defining a grid, the nodes of which are indicated as black dots on the section, where we can place the additional bars. Then, the bar properties, and the list of additional bars added to the section. First, we will select a grid at the section perimeter. Then, we will modify the grid spacing. For example, we can choose a dense grid in the horizontal direction and a sparse grid in the vertical direction. Let's bring the grid horizontal spacing to the initial value. And continue with saying other grid options, first, the perimetric and internal bar grid, where we can see that there are grid points at the perimeter and in the inner part of the section. Finally, if the grid does not work for us, with the third option, we can specify a single grid point with specific coordinates where we can place our bar. We can see that the single grid point location changes as we change the grid point coordinates. Let's now insert a bar in the desired position. We first select the bar diameter. And then, we click on the grid point to insert the bar. Also, a record appears in the additional reinforcement list, indicating specifications about the bar we just added. Let's now use the second gridding option. And choose to modify the bar we already introduced. We go and click on the bar, which now has a green color, indicating that it is selected. We can go and change the bar diameter. And we can see that the size of the bar is respectively modified. We can move the bar by selecting Move. Then, click on the bar. And then, click on the new desired bar position. And we can see that the bar's position changes. Finally, we can remove the bars by selecting the Remove option. And clicking on the bar that we want to remove. Notice that all the actions we saw can be carried out only for the additional bars and not for the bars belonging to the standard reinforcement patterns. Now, let's see the additional bar reinforcement menu for the columns, which looks and functions similarly to the one we saw for the beams. We select column C1. And we select the additional reinforcement option.